Hi, my name is Anthony Bakey. I'm the co-founder of XLAN, New Zealand's largest gaming events that were ever held. XLAN was run at multiple venues, so I guess as we grew, we had to change venues. I mean, our best one was the Tauchaclear Stadium. That was a large event. We had about 1,000 attendees, is what we'd like to think. I think it was just short at 980. It was in a different era of computer gaming. For us, it was months of planning. We had a volunteer crew of about 40 staff. It was a very, very large undertaking.
Just on 800 gamers in the arena there, we quite a few thousand spectators during the weekend, 14.5 kilometres of network cable, 900 single phase plugs.
Generally it was one big pinnacle of an event once a year to form the E-Blacks, to take them over to the World Cyber Games, which of course at that point of time was considered the Olympics of computer gaming. Yeah, so the World Cyber Games, I guess, is considered the pinnacle of computer gaming. Well, it was at that era anyway. It was the largest tournament in all the major games of that era. You know, the Warcrafts, the Starcrafts, the Counter-Strikes. There was console gaming as well. But in all those different aspects, there was it was to find, I guess, the equivalent of a world or Olympic champion for those games. It was a big deal. And it went around the world in some really interesting places where we got to take, the E-Blacks to. And it was quite a lucrative thing. I mean, it was a fully funded trip overseas to represent New Zealand. I mean, like, one of the most memorable is when the E-Blacks actually won the Asian Championship. So we actually bet, some of the large Asian countries and took out the whole tournament, a combination of, I guess, the whole team's result. One of the best results was, of course, our Warcraft 3 player at the time. He got a silver medal. Our Dota team, they placed as well. And our Guitar Hero player as well placed.
How did it feel to finally win for the second year in a row?
Pretty cool, though. Yeah.
Indeed, I'll hold up your big check so everybody can see. So Mason not only won gold, but he won 1,000 Singaporean dollars to go along with that, which is a fantastic achievement. The second gold medal New Zealand has ever won, both of them currently by Mason.
It was a combination of all these different genres placed really well, and we actually, like, winning the overall tournament was just something that New Zealand never would possibly achieve again. So I'd consider that the pinnacle in the E-Black side. And around just XLAN itself, I guess for me it was the scale we got to and what we created as a community. The gaming community changed over the years. We were running these events, but we just seemed to keep growing. And it wasn't just all about the really competitive gamers. It was definitely about, the community aspect that we really pulled together. And I guess that's something that's missed at the moment in the community, I imagine.